Running check disk when check disk won't run. Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Come sign up to my newsletter. I answer questions like this all the time, and if you sign up for the newsletter, you'll end up getting those answers, tips, tricks, and more in your inbox every week. askleo.com/newsletter for more. Here's the question. As administrator, I type checkdisk C/F, click enter, and get error message that the drive is being used. Of course, and do I want to run it the next time it starts? I type Y, hit enter, and it tells me it'll begin at startup. I close the window, hit restart, and the PC restarts. Except it restarts the normal way. No checkdisk at all. So I want to be clear. I don't have an answer for this specific problem. Honestly, I believe it's going to involve diving into the registry to clean something up that's been misconfigured. Instead, what I'm going to show you is a way to run CHKDSK anyway, manually. And in doing so, I think it'll open up some interesting venues for other diagnostic opportunities should you ever need them. So let's head over to Windows 11 right now. Even though this is Windows 11, everything that I'm showing you will apply to Windows 10 as well. It'll look a little bit different in Windows 10, but the concepts are very much the same. What I'm going to do is search for command to begin with and run it as administrator, simply so that I can show you what the original questioner is asking about. If I run CHKDSK space /F C:, it'll say, hey, the drive is in use. Well, of course it's in use. Windows is using it right now. So normally what would happen is you would say yes, and then you'd reboot and CHKDSK would run. For some reason, this person's CHKDSK isn't running. Okay, let's force it. What we're going to do instead this time is I'm right-clicking here and I'm going to click on Settings so that I can get to System, and then scrolling down in System, I will go to Recovery. Now, Recovery has a lot of different options. The one that I'm interested in here is Advanced Startup. We'll say Restart now. And yes, one of the things that's important to understand here is you are rebooting the PC, so make sure that you've not got anything open or work in progress, that you've saved it all beforehand. Okay, so we are now in this, I'll just call it the diagnostic or alternate boot menu that Windows has for these kinds of scenarios. What we want to do now is click on Troubleshoot. We're going to click on Advanced Options. And in Advanced Options is Command Prompt. Command Prompt is what we're interested in here, because now what we have is a Command Prompt window that will let us run CHKDSK on C. You'll notice that the current drive is X. What Windows has done is it has actually booted from a separate copy of Windows, presumably in one of the recovery partitions that we're never sure about what to do with. This is what they're there for. So we're running a copy of Windows, but it's not the normal copy of Windows. And what that means is that the normal copy of Windows isn't actually running and locking the drive. So if I can now go to C and I do a DIR, you'll see that it looks like the root of a C drive. It looks like the system drive. What that means is that I can now run CHKDSK /F C:, and it just runs. It will tell me that there are some open file handles here. That's because I made it the current drive. If my current drive were still over on X, this wouldn't happen. In any case, it doesn't really matter. We'll just say yes, and off it goes. It's running CHKDSK on C. This will run pretty quickly. Now, I will warn you that if you want to see the results of this CHKDSK, you have to look here. And I say that because normally when you run a CHKDSK on boot, the results are saved to the event log. Well, you'll notice that the very last line of this CHKDSK that just ran says unable to obtain a handle to the event log. That's because this restricted version of Windows that's running right now doesn't have one. It's not the same. And it can't actually write to the event log on the disk that it's checking. So if you want to see the results, don't leave. In other words, just look here. You can scroll up and down in this window to see exactly what the CHKDSK did, but you have now successfully run CHKDSK on your C drive. When you're done, all you really need to do is either close this window by clicking on the X or typing exit, and then you'll be given the opportunity to go back. Now, before we do that, I want to address one of the unfortunately common scenarios that I think throws people for a loop sometime. You'll notice that in this case, my current drive, this copy of Windows, was running from a drive called X. That's this reserved partition special copy. And it was C that was in fact the C drive for my system. Sometimes, and I think this might be a Windows 10 thing, but sometimes your system drive, your real system drive, the drive that you would normally think of as your C drive, will, in this scenario, not be assigned the drive letter C. That can be very, very confusing. So what do we do? How do we find out what drive letter it was assigned? Well, unfortunately, I haven't been able to find a truly elegant way to do it, but it's absolutely possible. What I'm going to do is I'm going to type a command, WMIC logical disk get name. And what that does is it lists all of the drives that this copy of Windows knows about. So you can see it knows there's a C drive, a D drive, an E drive, an F drive, a G drive, and the X drive. If we did not already know that the C drive of my system is in fact the C drive here, if we realize that whatever C drive is, it's not what we think, how would we locate our actual system drive, the real system drive for our system when it's running normally? Well, what I do is I just do a dir of each of these drives in turn until I find something that looks like my system drive. That looks like my Windows drive. Now, if I take a look at some of the other drives, you can see if I do a dir on D, there's a bunch of my Bacrium backup images. If I do a dir on E, there's something else, an old copy of Windows that I restored for examination purposes. But you get the idea. There are a number of ways of examining the drives that are here and then using the correct drive letter to do your operations. If, for example, we had determined that the system drive had instead been assigned the drive letter D, then we'd run CHKDSK on D, and that would give us the CHKDSK of our true system drive. Once we reboot back into Windows normally, it'll be C again. It's only during this administrative command prompt in this recovery console that we might end up with different drive letters. But as we saw, at least in this copy of Windows 11, it came up with the right drive letter. If not, WMIC is the tool to use to figure out what drive letters you have, and then you can simply take a look at each one in turn to understand which one might in fact be your true system drive. Now, I hope you find this interesting, because there's a lot more that you could do besides CHKDSK here. In fact, if we go back to the X drive, which is where we're running from, you can see we're in Windows System 32. If we do a dir here, there's a lot. In fact, I'll just do a dir of star.exe, because this is a list of all the programs that are here in this recovery console. These are all tools that potentially could be used for whatever diagnostic work you happen to be doing. CHKDSK is one of them. There are a bunch of others, but this is how you get to them. Now, like I said, when you're done, you could type exit, or you can just close that window and then click on continue, exit and continue to Windows 11, and the system will reboot and bring you back to your system normally as you expect. I hope you find that helpful. I hope you find it kind of interesting. Actually, I know I do. For comments, for updates, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/154576. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.